let us understand what is MIS. MIS means M-I-S. What is M-I-S? If you see M-I-S, the long form of MIS stands for M for management. I for information. S for system. Management, information, system. This MIS you can have at your home. MIS you can have in your working organization. Right? So this is at home because children are there, lot of activities are there, okay? Financial support, strategy making, everything is required at home. Because you start making strategy, you know, like what your son should be, what your daughter should be. You plan it or not? Organization. Working organization is our company. It is also like a home. Right? In home, you cook. Here also we melt the steel. Their product is made. Here also we make a product. There lot of input will come. Ration. Ration item. Ration item is an input, no? Raw material. Is you simply buy raw material? No, no. You will check raw material, go select what brand, which, how it performed earlier. So, in a home, ladies are known to be the best managers. For them, all MIS is in the fingertip. They know that which rice was brought, from where, which source, whether in that month has performed well or not. Management information system should help us to improve. Once you say the word improve, what it should be? It should be measurable. Right? So what are the indicators you are considering in a management information system in the context of home or in the context of working organization? Whatever the elements you are considering, that element should be, the basic criteria for that element should be, it should be measurable. And you must know in what context you are having MIS. Home, MIS. Working organization, MIS. So coming to working organization, there are many sections. Name the sections right from incoming to outgoing. This is the organization. Then material comes to stores. It's like purchase, stores, then production, right? Then comes QA, right? Then comes inspection, then comes lab, then comes dispatch. Right? So there are many other sections. This for stores, separate MIS, production, quality, inspection, lab, there can be different MISs. These are all sectional level MIS. But as an organization level MIS, these are the input which comes to organization level MIS. Then they prepare one MIS. Okay. So, how to decide on MIS? That is very important. If you look at the design of MIS, see, designing of MIS is a key factor for success. It is very important. In that, how to design the MIS? We should design the MIS element, that is the information. It should be in line with company strategy. There will be some strategy in the company. There will be some vision, mission, some strategy. So whatever the MIS we design, that should be in line with company strategy.
right? For example, we want to have a QA department MIS where we are sitting here, right? There are many other sections in QA. What are the sections? Incoming, right? Then comes SMS lab or SMS QA. Then comes RMS QA. Then comes MATLAB. Designing of MIS, it should have an information that should be in line with the company strategy. You should always select CSF. What is CSF? We have to identify an element which is critical to success. Company's strategy, point number one. Point number two, we have to identify an element which decides the success of the organization. So that management term for that is CSF, critical success factor. Balanced scorecard. You know, you must have attended some big classes. Not required. It is a very simple thing. Then I have some other things like operational management, Toyota production systems, like different topics are there. Like barriers for communication, what are the types of communications are there? Right, like personal branding, that is very important. We have put any effort to brand our image? We don't. We have a skill. Each and every person has a skill. He has a skill. He has a skill. Everybody has a skill. Out of fear or out of shyness, we don't brand our image. But we should learn what.